Tonight, NPR and PBS are vowing a legal fight with President Trump after he issued an executive order instructing the Corporation for Public Broadcasting to defund the organizations. They're arguing he can't do that. His order claims that America's two biggest public broadcasters should not get the more than $500 million in taxpayer funds to public radio and TV stations nationwide because he argues they don't present, quote, a fair, accurate, or unbiased portrayal of current events. Despite the president's order, the CPB is a private entity, and it was created that way by Congress to insulate it from political pressure. NPR tonight says it's going to challenge this order, and the chief executive over at PBS said this, and I'm quoting her now, "The president's blatantly unlawful executive order issued in the middle of the night threatens our ability to serve the American public with educational programming as we have done for the past 50-plus years." All of this comes as the president's newly proposed budget that we were just talking about with the congresswoman would cut more than $6 billion from NASA as it moves the agency's focus away from space science to primarily getting astronauts to the moon and to Mars. My source tonight is Bill Nye, who we all know from PBS as Bill Nye, the science guy and also the CEO of the Planetary Society. And it's great to have you back here, sir, because obviously, you know, you've reached countless people through PBS over the years, fostering a love and an understanding for some of us of science. I wonder what you make of this news tonight.
Well, it's not good news for us. For it will be in modern terms, it will be unpopular. And so they'll find that a great many small communities rely on public broadcasting for weather information, for evacuation information, and so on. And then everybody who's a parent has raised their kids using public broadcasting children's programming. There's nothing like it. And that's why the organization was created, the system was created, and that's why people are going to push back against this. The citizens will, this will be very unpopular with members of Congress and the Senate. They will push back. And this is another executive order that was made for reasons that aren't entirely clear. But it will not, people won't, I don't think will stand for it. And the legal issue will go on, I guess, for a long time.
You personally must have interacted and encountered so many people over the years who have talked about how beneficial that was to them or to their kids or to their families.
Well, it's not millions or tens of millions. Hundreds of millions of people watch the Science Guy show. Thank you all. Put my heart and soul into that thing. And this is elementary science that is for many people that I have spoken with. Is sort of the main science they got in middle and often high school. And so the reason we made that show and the reason the show was made at that education level is it was based on very compelling research back in the 20th century about what people needed to get this fundamental understanding of science. And what, you know, everything happens for a reason, Kaitlan, and that reason, it's usually physics. So if you want to have this advanced military capability, this, for example, this Golden Dome, you're going to need people in the pipeline to come be engineers and physicists, scientists to build this extraordinary system. And those people are going to get their love of science from public broadcasting. So this is this is very well documented and so on. This is not in the national interest, and it will be unpopular.
In terms of how you did that and how you accomplished that, which I do think some people may say, I don't remember what I learned in the sixth grade, but I remember what I learned watching Bill Nye, and he did it in a way that I could remember it and understand it, and it was actually enjoyable. I just want to take people back for a moment and remind them of some of what that was like.
Imagining distances in space is difficult because everything is so far apart. But think of it this way. Let's say that this miniature soccer ball is the size of our sun, and it's right on the goal of a soccer field. How far do you think it is to the next star? Well, it's not in here. It would be here. The nearest star would be here.
7 hours of highway driving, about 700 kilometers away.
I mean, you watch that, everyone loves that, and they just, you know, it's an understanding of it. But I wonder, given what we just talked about with NPR and PBS, also cutting the NASA budget by 24%, which is his goal, doesn't mean it's going to happen, but that's what they want to do, and also moving it, you know, to prioritizing sending people to the moon and to Mars. What do you make of that?
Well, it's very troubling, you know. So the Planetary Society was started by Carl Sagan, a visionary who realized that the public interest in space exploration was very high and government support of it was not back in 1980. And so that turns out it's true again today. Now, everybody, objectively, I have a very competent staff at the Planetary, along with 42,000 members around the world. We have very competent staff who have analyzed the NASA budget over the last five decades. We've spent about $23 billion to study the planet Mars, get rocks sampled. Geologists are into rock samples from exactly the right place on Mars to learn the most what we think about where there was water and where there were signs of life. The current administration is planning to abandon that, program. That's just a fantastic waste of tax dollars. That's, if I may, ripping us off. Furthermore, Mars is just one example. We have a mission on the way to Europa, the moon of Jupiter, twice as much ocean water as the Earth. We have missions on the way to a moon of Saturn. Everybody, this is in no one's best interest. Furthermore, NASA is the best brand the United States has. By abandoning funding for NASA at this extraordinary level, right now NASA science cut is 25%. That's the biggest cut since the Apollo. I was alive for the Apollo era when President Nixon was concerned that somebody's going to die in the moon exploration. So they turned it off. And this cut's even bigger than that. And the cut to NASA science, 47%, yeah. By one report, 48%, would be a so-called extinction-level event. For NASA science, this is in no one's best interest. And even Tom Cole from Oklahoma, very conservative guy, is very concerned about this. And I think the people on the other side are going to have a great deal of difficulty. What is the most untrustworthy person on Earth for people on the other side? Yes, an unelected government bureaucrat. Well, apparently it's a guy at the Office of Management and Budget, Russ Vought, who's behind all this. And so we'll see how long members of Congress and Senate put up with this.
Yeah. And of course, the Senate just confirmed him to that position, Senate Republicans. Bill Nye, no one better to talk about this with than you. Thank you for joining us on a Friday night.
Thanks, you guys. Thanks for including us. Let's work together and make the world better for everyone.
Great to have you. Thank you so much.